Hello, everyone, and welcome to our Saturday stream. I'm sorry I was gone last week due to being all of the tired and having to have all of the sleep that everyone has ever had ever. So we're continuing on with our Saturday stream, and yes, hello, YouTube, because the stream is going to continue to be posted to YouTube since enough people, well, a lot of people did ask me to please keep doing it. So, I mean, it seems like people are enjoying it. We'll continue posting it to YouTube then. Now, what are we doing this week in terms of games or interactive entertainment? Well, you know, something that people said was that we've been doing CDI titles, interactive multimedia, for a while. We still do have a few to do, but we have been doing it pretty much nonstop for like 2 months. So I thought that maybe we could do something a little different and start off with perhaps a PC game. You know, one of the fine titles that you could find on Steam. You know, there's a lot of quality games that can be found on Valve's... things are crashing. I mean, it seems like Hitbox might be having a little bit of trouble this week, and sometimes it does. But as far as what we're going to do on the PC, oh man, can't wait to see what it is we're going to be doing here. So we're going to be playing a very, a very good-natured, very whimsical title that can be found on Steam that goes by the name of Blackbay Asylum. So, I mean, that is the intro to Blackbay Asylum. We're bringing in a very large man who apparently murdered a bunch of people. I guess we'll find out the full backstory, the full lore. Hopefully Hitbox doesn't pass out too often, because it's happened a couple times right now. We have a little teddy bear right here. Well, it's a slow-paced game, even if Hitbox is having problems. Hopefully we won't have... We won't miss too much. All right, let's start off with chapter one. Welcome to Blackbay. Gives us a little backstory. Our main character is Doug Donahue, convicted mass murderer and patient at Blackbay. He's in a cell, composing a letter to his best friend, a teddy bear. How adorable. I'm sure this is going to be a very likable, well-adjusted character. But what seems to be very ordinary is about to take a horrific turn. Okay. I played a little bit of... I'm sorry. I'm not sitting down, but... So here's the letter. So, he is scheduled for exploratory surgeries. And it seems like this does not usually turn out very well. He's sorry for all those people he killed. But he wants Teddy to escape because he really doesn't fit in to this mental institution. Let's continue. All right. So, let's have an overhead perspective. Okay. All right, let's see what this is about. Don't leave your cell. Listen and obey. This seems all fine, all very standard. I don't see anything wrong with any of this. probably should have taken a look at the controls. Oh, there we go. Up here, next. All right. We just got a little bit of backstory for Blackbay, and the chat has been left in the dark again. I mean, it kind of follows, you know, the theme of the game. You know, it's just all very mysterious and strange, and what's even happening here? So it follows that the video would keep cutting out. Now, Blackbay Asylum, you should probably know, whenever someone mentions it, it is in the context of that the game is terrible. That's kind of the opinion people seem to have for it. But, I mean, we're gonna give it a chance. That is weird. I mean, this does seem like a very dangerous place. Why would there be no guards around? We can't really see that. But it is an automatic machine gun? I mean, this has to be a pretty intense asylum if they have something like that here. We can interact, or at least observe, with pretty much everything. Oh, look at this. Trail of blood. But this... yeah, it's locked. Pretty sure he used to be alive. I mean, the last time we saw him, seemed like he was alive. I mean, we could be wrong. But we took his key card. Yes, this is Arkham Asylum, Spammy V. This is like an overhead perspective Arkham Asylum. Hey, you! What the hell happened? It's a lot of blood in this room. This is Arkham Asylum before Batman gets here. Oh, let's see. To use our inventory. All right, there we go. Here's a journal. Dear Diary. Tonight, my cell door was open and not a guard in sight. I should take this opportunity to escape. Teddy's nervous, but everything will be fine. Sure. Alright. No? Okay, there we go. We have no time for rest. We have to find out what's going on here. Ah, porn and weapon magazines. Is there a better combination for your run-of-the-mill prison guard? Or asylum guard? It's kind of both. Alexis, you say? Oh, okay. We need a password. I wonder what it could be. How about that? Alright, so, I mean, I guess you do have to change the password on a monthly basis in most places, so I guess that guard was just going with the name on the monthly magazine. Okay. Alright, a screwdriver. Yep, there it is. It's a nice looking screwdriver. But is there anything we've seen that we could use this with? I mean, that thing is still there, and it's gonna kill us. Actually, let me see, is the turret okay, it's deactivated, okay. When we entered the password... yeah. When we entered the password, he must have turned it off. We hacked one computer today, and that's more than most people do in an entire week. Well, I mean, I don't think... we can't even see what the picture is that he hates. Well, I don't think anyone's going to mind us being in the ladies' room since it doesn't really seem like anyone's actually here. Except that person in the stalls. We need our glasses. I guess they took them away when we were put in this place. Yeah, it's probably not important. Oh, my head hurts. That's how I say it, too. It seems like some weird things happened here. Yep. That's why we don't. Because if... I mean, look at what happened to this guy. He read a book, and he ended up smashed into the bookshelf, bleeding out. That's what'll happen. It's good. That's how it happens to you. Well, I think we're jumping the gun here, assuming that this guy was murdered. I think that there is some room for doubt. Oh, well, I mean, I don't think we have any numbers that we can put into this. Try 666? I mean, that seems like the type of edginess that Blackbay Asylum would have. I wonder what could be in the basement. Yeah! Who do they think we are? We're a civilized... incarcerated murderer. We don't take the stairs. Alright, we're outside. I guess we could try to get out. Oh, wonderful. Alright, this truck crashed into the front gate, and I guess that is stopping us from actually leaving. Alright, we wanted a few cents. I guess we got them now. We can't climb over it? What are you thinking? We're not even willing to climb upstairs. We're not climbing over a truck. This was the fate of our fellow inmates. I mean, it seems like something kind of weird is happening at Blackbay Asylum. I mean, I don't want to alarm anyone. I think maybe not everything here was on the up and up. You know what I'm saying? I think there's some secrets to be found in this place. It's a sequel to Dementium 2. It kinda is Dementium, but with a more interesting main character. We have a screwdriver, we have a gas can, we have exactly 75 cents, and we wrote in our journal. Teddy's getting a really bad vibe from the women's bathroom. If only there was some way to see inside, just like back in school. Alright, we need our glasses to do that, and we know that much. Where might they be? Well, I mean, I don't think we have time to check. It's very dark. It's kind of hard to see what we're doing here. This game has super bad it humor. I mean, it does have some it humor, I guess. Humor about it, I suppose. A vending machine. Something's in it, but we can't get to it. I wonder how we might dislodge something out of the vending machine. Well, that's kind of odd. We can't use the elevator. Alright, let's go to our inventory. Let's put some money in there. Oh, hold on. We got prescription glasses. Okay, glasses were stuck in the vending machine. Because, I mean, that happens. I mean, sometimes, you know, at work, I will go to the snack machine. And then I'll get like a bag of chips. And then I'll realize I can't see so well. Then I look back at the vending machine and my glasses are in there. And I'm like, oh no! I have to call maintenance now. And I have to explain this again. I don't know how it happens. Do I have a map? I don't think there is a map, at least not yet. Alright, we have our glasses. Let's have a look in here. Alright. I think we can remember that. Can I? Oh, there we go. Now, have we seen anything that we could enter numbers in? Maybe one thing. All right, what do we got in here? Whoop. Beer and porn. Of course that's what's in here. Oh, a generator, but it's out of gas. Well, I think we're in luck. Oh no, what? Okay, we have gas and the generator works, but what about this fuse? Looks like that there's a fuse box over here. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Alright, here's this voltage meter, and here are these switches. Now, you might wonder, you know, how do you... Well, we know that we have to get 300, because, you know, it's in the green, so at least we can figure that out. What numbers should we have to put in here, these green, blue, and yellow dials? What numbers would result in the proper answer? Is there anything here that's green, blue, and yellow that could give us some clues as to what the numbers would be? Is there anything at all on the screen that has colors that match? I mean, we could try 666, since so many people want me to enter that. I mean, it doesn't do anything. After all, any biblical scholar knows 616 is the number of the beast. But, let's see, green. For some reason, I don't know, I'm getting a feeling that maybe the number for green should be 3, you know? And then for blue? What should the number for blue be? I'm sure there is, like, a number of blue things that might be on the screen or something. I don't know. Yellow? I mean, is there two? Okay, so we got it. I mean, if only there was something on the screen that gave me a clue on what these numbers were. I just got it by pure luck myself. So. Well, that's odd. That didn't look like an inmate, did it? Not at all, really. I mean, I guess we could go inside and see what's happening in here. Ah, stainless steel. There's nothing quite like it. It's true, there isn't anyone in that chair. Now, really, you shouldn't run with scissors. It is kind of dangerous. The doctors seem to be up to maybe no good? Well, I shouldn't assume. You know, I mean, when you actually see someone do it, you realize, hey, you know, that hurts. People are getting hurt. Huh, how about that? All right, this is the room that we just saw. You know, I have a feeling that everyone wishes they called in sick today. Well, I guess we got to know this guard pretty well. It doesn't seem like there's anything else in here, though. Maybe we should remember that name. B. Hansen, you say? How long were we in here? I mean, it didn't seem like we were here for very long. The impression I got was kind of that we just... that we basically just kind of got here, but I don't know. Simple lock. Our fingers won't work, though. Maybe we could find something a bit thinner. Oh, or maybe we already have something that's a bit thinner. All right, we're able to use simple tools. I don't know if we have a need for that quite yet.
Hey!
What? Someone just called to us. Did we lose the screwdriver? Yeah, we lose something when we use it, but we got something in our journal. Yep, he's just writing down comments in the journal about the stuff that we're doing. Alright, let's talk to the dumpster and see what's happening.
Hey, you! Are you crazy? Walking around out there with those things?
I mean, I guess you can decide how we'll answer. Should we go with 1, 2, or 3? As you can also get a full body view of our character here, who is decked out in t-shirt and diaper. Alright, looks like most people are saying that we should ask, what is this guy doing in this trash container? It does seem like the most practical answer.
This is no trash container. It's my impenetrable fortress. And no, there's no room for you.
How do we respond to this? I mean, it is a pretty sweet dumpster. I think anyone would want to get in there. Like, this guy knows what he's got. He's probably going to charge us rent or something to get into the dumpster. That's pretty even right now. The chat kind of torn with itself over how we should respond. So I guess I'll end this vote in 3, 2, 1. Looks like number one. We promised to behave.
No. Well, there is maybe one thing you could do to gain entrance, but it's very dangerous.
You know, somehow I doubt Doug really cares about danger.
Before I could make it to my fortress, I was hiding among my friends in the yard. And while crawling around in their bloody remains, I lost my precious time machine. Now you must go find it for me.
Well, I mean, we could probably make use of a time machine ourselves. But what's dangerous about doing this?
Why? No, I guess it's not very dangerous. However, this is your quest. Now go, young knight, and honor your king.
What accent is this? I mean, it's... I'm not an accent expert. I'm not an expert with the accents and dialects of the world, but I'm sure this is, a completely genuine accent and not something that someone is just making up.
You still crazy?
I guess let's ask around and see what it is we can find out by him from this.
To face those monsters out there. That's why I'm right here, where it's safe.
Does he know anything about these things?
Why, they're dragons from the realm of Actosh, of course. Where have you been for the last 600 years?
I mean, I guess we should have known that. It's pretty obvious when you think about it.
You don't recognize your king? Damn! If you can recognize me, so can the dragons! Ah!
I mean,
you still... Oh? Did you find it?
Alright, so it seems that's pretty much everything. We got a quest, a side quest, I guess, to find the time machine. Hopefully we can find it. A game of Hangman. Oh, there's someone here. Oh, what's going on? How you doing, Chef? He has a meat cleaver, and I'm sure we would like to have it. maybe we can find some way of getting that cleaver from him. If you saw it from above, this might look like a keypad. That doesn't really make much sense. I'm sure Doug's gone for a while without eating anything, so he must be famished. Okay, we have another puzzle. We have a keypad. Oh no, not our favorite hallway. Can we romance the cook? I mean, maybe, but I think we have more important things on our mind than romance. I wonder what all of this means. It's a mystery. I'm just gonna go back up to this, and I'm just gonna take a guess at this. I don't know. That was just random. Oh, I think maybe this has not been cleaned for a while. Something really sharp, like maybe a meat cleaver? Maybe. Glasses won't do it. Maybe there's a way to quiet him down so we can get the cleaver, though. Alright, so I mentioned that I played a little bit of this before. This is where I got. And I don't know what to do next. I know that we have to calm down, we have to quiet down Chef, so we can get the cleaver. We have to find the time machine. I haven't seen anything like that. We have to find something sharp to cut through the curtain, and it's probably the cleaver. Someone asked how much this game costs. Obviously, whatever I paid for it is a bargain for this. Can we interact with the chef? Try going back to the yard with the corpses. All right, let's head back there. Oh, did he actually say that the time machine was out with the corpses outside? Well, Doug seems pretty sure that he's not going to dig through this. We should use a tool to dig. We have no tools right now. Use the glasses to dig. I don't think that's a great tool to dig with, though. I don't think most asylums have instructions for executions. This is a special asylum. Maybe gloves? Maybe so. We don't actually have any other items. We've picked up everything that we have been able to find. What's on the picnic table? It's some money. We don't need any more, though. And we did use the glasses to peek through the bathroom. And we found out the number was 1984, which we were able to make use of. But is there any items that we can pick up that will let us dig through the corpses? Any gloves? Any shovels? look at the dirt with the glasses. Now let's try it. I mean, I don't have anything better to suggest, so let's head back out there and try using the glasses. And see if that will make something visible that we were not able to see previously. Does not seem so. The lawnmower? I mean, that seems really difficult and messy to try to dig through corpses with a lawnmower. Which, I mean, that might mean it's actually the answer, but we needed some way of fixing it. What was the name of this game again? It's Blackbay Asylum. Is the name of the game. Yeah, we could try to fix it, but we don't have anything to try to use. My father always said, don't leave a bloody mess, you asshole. Oh, Dad. Always remembering those wise words that he had to impart. Use the glasses on the lawnmower? I guess we could. There is no guide on Game Facts. I always love when we're playing something that no one has actually made a fact for. People make facts of everything. And there is no fact of this. I mean, we still have the glasses. So, it should mean that there's something that we need to use these glasses for. I could use the glasses on Chef, but you know, I don't think that would do anything. Talk to Dumpster Guy again. Did Club 3DO have a game fax? I hope it did.
You still crazy?
I mean, it's the same thing, same stuff.
Yeah, I suppose one have. Yes, I believe Chef is preparing a grand meal. You still crazy?
Do we have any way to attack? No. No, we really don't have any options aside from just interacting with things and looking at things. Oh, look around where the chef is. There's something else here I should be paying attention to. This is an adventure game, so just start rubbing up against everything. Yeah, it looks like... Oh, metal detector? Why do we have this? All right, I mean, I guess we can use it. Why was there a metal detector in the kitchen? And what, I mean, I'll have to check the video, but it didn't look like it was actually something that stood out from the background. So I guess the objective of this game is indeed to rub up against everything while hammering the space bar. I guess that's how this works. Oh, okay. Found a broken pocket watch. And I guess we can assume this is the time machine. Because of course it is. All right.
You still crazy? Oh, did you find it? Ah, marvelous. 10:05 exactly as before. I'm afraid I can't let you into my fortress, though. But I will give you this reward. It's the heart of that mechanical beast over there. Now go away.
Well, we succeeded in our quest, it's true.
Is it crazy?
What do we got? Oh, the spark plug. Let's see. Nothing new in here. Okay, the heart of the beast. I mean, sure. I guess we just did that. I think I see the hand over here. Yes, this is pretty dead alive-ish. Oh no, we already have this, okay. We are a terrible person. Well, I mean, that's why we're in Blackbay Asylum. We wouldn't be here otherwise. This costs money? Look, I don't know why you would be questioning that this quality product would cost you money on Steam. Hey, we made a checkpoint. Great. So we're on the other side of the elevator. Do we do anything here? Oh, there we go. Okay. Read before operating. Emergency or low power usage requires the master switch, voltage regulator, and fuse slash breaker. Alright, looks like we got some kind of puzzle going on here. Alright, let's see. Master switch, which is... I mean, it's this one. I don't know if... I'm not really sure what I'm doing here. Okay, voltage regulator, which is this one. Fuse breaker, which is this one. What am I doing? Click and drag? Well, I mean, I'm dragging. Okay, great. All right. Don't explain that. Don't say anyone say anything. We're just going to pretend that we did that on purpose. I am the puzzle master. I am the king of puzzles. Oh dear. Well, maybe that's enough for Blackbay Asylum. I don't know. Do you want to come back to Blackbay Asylum? Next time? Maybe we'll take it to a vote. Let's say number one for yes and number two for no. Do you want to return to Blackbay Asylum? Oh, holding shift lets you run. Which is something obviously I needed for that. Keep in mind, I'm the king of puzzles, not the king of running away, so that was a little difficult for me. Well, it seems, it seems like yes is going up. Yes is over double of no. Which is which? One is yes, two is no. Do we want to go back to Blackbay Asylum? One yes, two no. It looks like one has one. It looks like that we will be returning to Blackbay Asylum. I guess next week. So I guess that's going to be it for Blackbay Asylum right now. Let's move on to something a bit less bloody, maybe. And that means returning to the Philips CDI. Because we still do have CDI games to go through. But like I said, we'll try to get a bit more variety going on. Including games from the PC, you know, other systems, maybe new releases coming out. And get some stuff going on like that. But we still do have some things that we really do. We have some unfinished business with the CDI. That we have to get through. And part of that unfinished business is Dark Castle. I don't say that with a smile on my face. If you're not familiar with Dark Castle, It's not something anyone says with a smile on their face. I played some of this on the Genesis a while back, because there's a Genesis version. I haven't played the CDI version, because why would anyone want to play Dark Castle? I don't have the answer to that. Which is worse, the Genesis or the CDI version? I have not played the CDI version. The CDI version is going to have more colors, it's going to have better audio, I'm sure. Don't know if the controls are any different. Alright, here we are. So, we choose which door we're going to go in. Let's see, there are four doors. Hey, chat, why don't you decide which one I go in? Vote 1 through 4, going left to right. So number 1 and 2 have question marks above them. Number 3 has a skull above it. And number 4 has what looks like a shield? That's what I think I'm seeing. Three and four are kind of tied. It looks like 3 is going up. I mean, 3 does have this badass skull on the top of it, so it's probably going to win. So, okay. End the vote. We're going in door number 3. Let's do this thing. Let's play some Dark Castle, which is, again, something no one has ever said. All right. Black Knight 1. Let's see what this room has for us. Okay, the way the game controls. We die. That was just a coincidence, but I mean, that is how the game works. You die. You just die. You die. You don't do anything else, but you die. Okay, so... Alright, so we can walk back and forth. I can throw rocks. I can... get killed by bats. I can jump. Let's see. I'm supposed to be able to control the direction of... Well, I'm not able to really control anything, honestly. Alright, I control the direction of the rocks that I'm throwing with the D-pad. For some reason, I'm not throwing rocks. Why am I not throwing rocks? I want to throw some rocks. I don't know why I'm not throwing rocks. Did I just trip? Oh, yes. Oh, yes. We have the most... The thing about Dark Castle is that you are controlling what is probably the most incompetent main character ever in a video game. And I'm stuck on... Okay. Okay. Even more incompetent than Mike Dawson. Hey, Mike Dawson ended up winning in the end. I mean, he went through a lot to get there, but he did win in the end. So, you're seeing what's happening here. I've mentioned that there really isn't anything wrong with the CDI controller. Like, the gamepad I'm using is not bad. So I just want you to keep in mind that I'm not using the remote control or anything. Well, Mike Dawson won in Darkseed 1. Maybe not so much 2. But he did win in 1. More incompetent than Lester the Unlikely? Oh, Lester the Unlikely is like Nathan Drake in comparison to this guy. How much did this game sell for when it was released? Oh, this was a retail game. You know what, Dark Castle? I am not going to put my name into you. You're not going to get that satisfaction. I usually don't do a game or an interactive title for that short amount of time. But you saw what was happening there. Like, it doesn't actually play any better than that. It doesn't get any better. If you want to actually play Dark Castle, I think you actually have to be pretty dedicated in getting good at it. And I mean, by getting good, I mean being able to play the basic controls of it. You have to really want to do it. You have to put in the time and the effort and the dedication to grasp the basic controls of Dark Castle. But we're not talking about Dark Castle anymore, we're talking about Lords of the Rising Sun. Is there a Taz of Dark Castle? I've seen a speedrun of the game, or at least the Genesis game. I don't know what this is, by the way. Let's preserve history. No, I can't pick that. I can launch a rebellion.
It is a dark time for the Minamoto. Kiyomori, leader of the Taira clan, has imprisoned me in this cell, soiling the last vestige of our family honor. My father, Yorimasa, has committed seppuku. After his defeat at the Battle of Usui River, leaving the fate of our rebellion in your hands, the Taira armies and castles must be annihilated. The imperial regalia retrieved and our honor restored. The time for action is now. My fate lies in your hands.
All right, so there's a very sad woman in a bamboo prison, and I guess, you know, I don't know.
Which of the Minamoto brothers, Yoritomo or Yoshitsune, will lead your troops in battle by moving the thumbstick left to right and pushing action button 1 when the desired character's name is highlighted? If you need help in deciding which character to play, move the thumbstick until the helmet icon in the middle of the screen is highlighted and push action button 1.
Turning up the volume a little bit. Okay, so we know, I mean, obviously everyone knows the advantages and disadvantages between Yoritomo and Yoshitsune, and I mean, I'm not gonna, you know, go over that with you, because I know this is all old hat to you. I know that you already know all the differences, so pick 1 for Yoritomo, pick 2 for Yoshitsune, and, you know, I mean, I'm sure that you know who is who. By the way, did someone say that the Dark Castle speedrun was an hour? No, the Dark Castle speedrun is 1 minute. 1 minute. That's how fast you can beat it. If you can actually play the game. It looks like number 2 was winning, so we're gonna pick Yoshitsune.
General Yoshitsune, your men are ready. We await your orders.
All right. Okay. We have a cursor on the screen. I can solicit advice, review the troops, enter our home, prepare to march. Let's solicit some advice.
You have entered help mode. To hear explanations of any of the choices on this banner, move the pointer to the choice in question and push action button 1. To exit help mode, move the pointer to the samurai helmet icon at the top of the banner and push action button 1.
All right, I mean, thank you for telling me how to use the cursor,
Troops. Utilizing this option, you can gather information on the number and health of the troops under your control.
You know, I don't mean to criticize, but this has to be the most bored narrator I've heard in a video, in an interactive title. He does not seem to be too into what's happening
here.
Enter
home castle. Inside your home castle is a council room. It is there you may decide to hire a ninja assassin to kill one of your enemies represented by the banners on the center wall. You can also commit seppuku with the sword on the center wall if all hope is lost.
I mean, look at that. You're talking about hiring a ninja to assassinate our enemies, and you're making that sound like the most boring thing in the world. And yes, it did sound like he couldn't really get out seppuku. Not sure how he pronounced that.
Prepare to march. This will bring you to the map of Japan where you can begin plotting your attack strategy.
All right, I guess we'll exit help mode and review the troops. I mean, I'm sure we'll end this by committing seppuku, but first we should at least see what the game is actually like. Okay, I just exited the review, okay. It's just it shows you that graphic, and I guess...
Your men are ready. We await your orders.
All right, let's go in my house. All right, what do we have? There's always that. Hire ninjas? All right, let's assassinate your Tomo with a ninja.
Ah, Yoshitsune. Services such as mine are not to be taken lightly, nor are they inexpensive. I will dispose of the one you have requested. As far as our conversation is concerned, it has never occurred.
So, can I kill the other generals just that easily? I assume that...
Men are ready. We await your orders.
I assume there's a chance that won't work, because otherwise, like, that seemed real easy. Yeah, he's not wearing enough orange. This seems like a very historically inaccurate representation of ninjas. Well, I mean, seriously, yes it is, because ninjas did not wear that. Ninjas just look like normal dudes, normal Japanese dudes. Yes, he did look like a normal Japanese dude. They just all wore clothes like that. Okay, I can pick something. I'll hit the gray thing in the middle. No, that doesn't work. I'm gonna move this sword over the map until it changes colors. And then maybe we can click on something. Nothing's happening so far. Oh, wait. No, hold on. I mean, I think that the help part where it was talking about click the tiny flag. I think the help part where it was talking about the how we operate in the menus. I don't think it really needed to go over that. I think maybe it needed to go over what it we're supposed to do when we get to this screen. Nothing seems to be happening when I click on anything. Oh, hold on. No? Alright, I think I'm out of my depth here. Click the helmet. Alright, let's see. Where is that helmet? And there it is. Nothing's happening.
Entered help mode. Information on castle locations, maneuvering armies, and mapping strategies is contained in the enclosed booklet.
So the help is just read the manual? You have a manual, right? You should go read that. Oh, it's you.
It's well deserved, my lord. But I feel the cold shadow of my destiny approaching. I fear my time is running out.
How am I talking to you? Like, where are you? I mean, am I her captor?
I praise your efforts and await the honor of your presence.
I don't know how we're talking. Or is she captured by our opposition? Oh, we're back here again. How do I get back to that initial menu? Alright, let's see if we can restart the game and just do what you want to do.
Your rest is well deserved, my lord.
It sure is. I mean, I'm sure there is a lot to this game. I'm sure there is. It did seem like there was a training mode there, so, I mean, maybe that's what you're supposed to do before you actually really get into it.
General Yoshitsune, your men are ready. We await your orders.
You know what order I'm gonna give. There's only one order left. Because we need to read the manual. Hooray! The memory of my leadership. I came into power and immediately killed myself. What a great leader. Everyone will remember me. Statues will be erected in my memory. I'm sure there is a lot to this. I just don't know what it is. Yeah, and I don't know who Prison Lady is, or who was holding her captive, or what she needed us to do. There's a speed run of this? Oh, well, no. Yeah, I guess there wouldn't be a speed run, because a speed run would be just committing seppuku immediately. What was the name of this game again? I believe it is Lords of the Rising Sun. Man, all of these memorable roles. We'll never forget Princess, Emperor, Adjutant, and Ninja. We salute you. Maybe I'll take a look at what the game actually is at some, like, just read up a little bit about it and see if it might be worthwhile to try to actually play it. For right now, let's move on. All right, well, here's the one that I think some of you have been waiting for. Is there a copy protection code? Okay, there was. So that'll have to wait for another time. That was Voyeur, by the way. I'm not sure if that was a copy protection code or if it was a parental code, because Voyeur is not for children. At least that's what the infomercial told me. We'll have to get to it on another time. People saying the code is 3333. What a difficult code. Right, so what we're doing is the Lost Ride, which I don't actually know what this is. But we're going into Mine World, I guess. Let's do it! This is pretty intense so far. This is really in my face. And, I guess we're playing? Oh, hold on. I'm shooting. Okay, so I can shoot. Oh, I can look to the left and right. So, I mean, it's a rail shooter because I don't think I can control where I go. Unless maybe I can shoot the directions when I get to those intersections. Oh no, out of ammo. I wonder if I pick any up. It is a little bit like Sewer Shark, isn't it? Except, of course, we don't have Ghost yelling at us and calling us dog meat. And without that, really, what does the game have? I guess let's try it again. I'll try to conserve ammo and see how far we can get. I mean, I don't know where we're going or what the objective is. I mean, I assume that we're going to come to the end of the level at some point. And then we'll go on to something new, but, really have not been given any sort of structure so far. Okay, I can adjust where we where we're going. I can shoot the sign. I don't know if this is better or worse than the other way. So, I guess there are some instant death paths, and I guess the objective of the game is to memorize what leads to instant death? I suppose? and just try to make sure that we don't go down those paths. Seems to be what's going on. Can I just hold the button down and shoot without aiming? I mean, we run out of ammo real fast if I just keep shooting. Oh, I don't think I shot that. We're going left. I think that's where we went last time, so this might lead to a giant bat that just kills us, unless this is a different part. It doesn't seem like there's a whole lot to this aside from what we're seeing. Just kind of keeps going on. Let's try going right, I guess. I don't know, for as intense as this seems to try to be, it's kind of uninteresting, isn't it? Maybe it's the lack of music? Oh no, there's that, okay. That's probably enough of the last ride, because honestly, it just keeps doing that. It doesn't seem like there's anything else to it, really. Maybe there would be if we didn't die and we got to the end of a level or something. But as it is, it just doesn't seem interesting enough to try to keep going. All right. So let's try going back to Voyeur. Does this work? It does. Okay. Okay. Why would you name your company that? Can I show this on the stream? Well, I don't know. It's getting kinda hot. Oh, goodness. It is the early 90s, and FMV is a new thing. Yes. What is happening?
Today, Hope Manor. Yes, everything is ready. I have them for you, sir. Frank? Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I'm afraid Frank's tied up right now. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
What's going on?
I mean, I'm sure they're old friends, and this is just sort of like a roleplay thing they do.
Get me out of these things. Damn.
Come on, Chantel. Yeah, see, it's just a thing they do every month.
There's always time for games, Frank.
All right, okay. Look, I promise I'll do the Peruvian sheep herder thing if you just let me up. Now, come on.
Oh, Frank. You know, I wonder what the future president of the United States would think if he finds you cuffed to his bed.
This is not funny.
His head of security,
damn it.
Huh?
Chantal.
Oh.
Uncuff me. Damn it. Uncuff me.
So much exposition.
Everything's so serious.
Get back here.
Have fun, Frankie.
Chantal! Damn it! God damn it!
Someone asked if we're a stalker in this game. Oh, no. We're a voyeur. Like, that's the name of the game is the premise. We have a camera, and we are recording some illicit goings-on. I'm going to watch TV.
Will he or won't he? This is Tish Van Alden, and that's the hot question on everybody's lips during this primary season. Billionaire bachelor and business genius Reed Hawk has yet to commit himself to the race for the Oval Office.
Is that Mitt Romney?
Well, hang on to your hats, folks, because he's gathering his flock this weekend to help him reach a decision. And when the Hawks get together, the feathers are bound to fly. I mean, imagine how his son Zachary must feel after his sudden promotion off the Missile Defense System project. Just in time for it to propel dear old Dad into the White House. Getting a little chilly in Daddy's shadow, Zach? And there's daughter Jessica winging her way in from Japan with a new bow and their own unique brand of environmental capitalism. Well, you may be a big success back in the land of the rising yen. But really, Jessica, considering your father's America First ideals, isn't this just asking for trouble? And of course, Reed's sister Margaret will be there to stake her claim to the First Ladydom. But Margaret, dear, please show some restraint. Rumor has it you're already shopping for your inaugural gown and planning the ball. Well, you better plan on trouble if your daughter Chloe shows up sporting her usual leather look. My God. Reed has paid a fortune trying to keep his niece's escapades out of the tabloids. Can you imagine what it'll cost him as president? Oh, wouldn't you just love to be a fly on the wall and listen in? Yes. Now we've gotten word that Reed Hawk is arriving at Hawk Manor. We go live to Jay Jacobson at the scene.
I'm glad that they just gave us all of the characters right there. That's very handy.
In the latest presidential polls.
Sounds like folks are ready for a change, doesn't it?
Your missile defense shield has virtually ended the threat of nuclear war, but does that make you the best man for president?
Never said I was. I leave that to the people to decide.
Come on, Mr. Hawk. Isn't it a fact you've already decided to spend whatever money you have to in order to buy this election, sir?
Excuse me. I don't think I know you.
Jacobson, Channel 6.
Well, Mr. Jacobson, my family always comes first. We're going to spend the next 2 days talking it over, and then I will decide about accepting the people's mandate. Now, if you're asking me, is the future of our country and the welfare of our children worth my risking my personal fortune? The answer is a resounding yes, it is. Okay? Have a great weekend, folks.
Still no decision from Reed Hawk. We'll bring you further reports as this story develops.
Huh. So he's a personally wealthy man who's running for president. I mean, he kind of looks like Mitt Romney. But I mean, this was made long before. This is like the early 90s. It's kind of uncanny. Well, anyway, you know, I'm glad that the TV that we were watching that on was a Philips TV. You know, that's nice synchronization right there. That's on message. What's this? Send the tape? I mean, I guess that's what we just recorded. I could send this tape to one of these characters. I guess I'll leave that to you. Let's say number one is upper left, number two is upper right, number three is lower left, number four is lower right. So let's say, number one is in the upper left, number two, again, upper right. So one and two are is the upper row, number three and four is the lower row. Looks like, so far, lower row is much more popular. We have Chloe, and we have Zach. So that seems to be those seems to be the characters that people are more interested in. than Margaret and Jessica. I guess let's end the vote. It looks like number three is winning. Chloe is who we're going to send this tape to. I mean, I don't know why. I don't know.
You came close, huh? Yeah, very close. Compliments of Mr. Hawk.
Oh, darn. We came so close. To I guess we got caught. Okay, all right. I mean, we recorded that tape. That was a great idea, Ken Goldstein. I mean, I think that we have to explore Ken Goldstein's idea a little bit more, but I guess what we can we move the camera? I don't know. You know exactly as much as I do at this point. I don't know if there's any what else we can do. So, we started off by recording that video. We watched the TV. Looked like we could interact with the phone. Maybe we could go back to the camera. And, yeah, do more spying before we send the tape. Yeah, I think that maybe we're not supposed to send the tape right away because we don't know who the tape should be going to. Really? Came so close to seeing Mitt Romney action. Oh, I can only hope. It's like Night Trap, but you're trying to get the deets for all these people. Yeah, it looks like you're trying to build up a case against this presidential candidate. A case of blackmail. And send out the proof of the improprieties to someone who is going to be able to do something with it. But it kind of just throws you right in. Could we do something else before sending it? Probably, yeah. I mean, there's probably other stuff we can do. It seems like sending the tape is maybe the end game itself? I'm not sure. It seems like the big action that we have to make a decision on. So I guess we should try to figure out what else we should be doing before we actually send that tape to anyone. Sending the tape is the end? Okay. The tape is the accusation, and you have one chance. Oh, we film a murder and send it to the news or the candidate. Oh, it just went to the dashboard. The candidate is giving the order to kill someone, and we send the tape to the person to warn them. Okay. So, we have not yet actually filmed anything that we can really nail anyone with. I mean, all we really recorded was some role-playing that was going on. And, you know, it might be embarrassing if someone saw it, but it's not really anything serious. Okay. We're back here. Let's see. Move the cursor. Oh, the phone. Hold on, there's a message.
I can contact you. We've got to stop Reed Hawk. Everything you need is in the apartment. You've received the dossiers on the different family members, and the video camera's set up and ready to go. If you can get incriminating evidence on tape, call the police. But make sure it's solid. This'll be our last chance. Look, this guy's capable of anything. Maybe you can figure out a way to warn the family members if they're in danger. But for God's sake, be careful. The future of this country's at stake. We're counting on you.
Okay, so if someone's in danger and we have the proof, call the police. And we could also send evidence to save someone. And we're trying to nail this Hawk guy. He's a danger. Okay, let's view Hawk Manor. Why not? Such smooth animation. I mean, it seems like the majority of the gameplay is going to be just looking at through the camera. Okay, we can move the camera around. We can zoom in. Oh, there are actually a bunch of windows we can look at, aren't there? And I guess, depending on the time, we will have different video clips that we can see. Alright, why not just work from left to right? Well, doesn't look like anyone's here. Am I zooming in on, like, something in the scene to read this? This does seem like the perfect presidential candidate. Wow, he's an astronaut, too! Oh yes, that's true. The only reason we're able to actually see this is because we have a Philips video camera. Philips. It's the name that you trust in high-quality electronics. So he's a war hero, he's an astronaut, and, like, he's a rich, like, captain of industry. So basically he can do anything. This is a pretty long press release. Not sure if this information is something we'll actually need. I mean, maybe the idea is maybe we can try to figure out if someone might be sympathetic to our cause? I don't know. I mean, if the only thing we're trying to do is film some evidence against Mr. Hawk, then I don't know if we actually need to know any of this. Let's move on, because that's pretty long. Wow, this is a really high-quality camera. Let's see. Is there some reason we would need to know about what books are on the shelf? We are indeed zooming and enhancing. Can we open the books? We don't quite have that technology. Wow, we spent 3 hours doing that, huh? And I see that we do have a battery meter, so I guess that is also going to act as kind of a time limit. Anyone in here? Oh, looks like D is in here. Uh-huh. I don't know if we really need to know this. Look for the eyeball icon. Okay, I mean, let's, Oh, man, I'm losing so much power. Let's go back and look for the eyeball. Now, there's one.
Here. Why do you continue to do this to
yourself?
Look,
we're not
going to
go into this again. I told you how important this weekend is to me. We're staying here, and that's it. Let me please just deal with my father.
Mr. Hawk, can I help you?
What the hell's with the elevator, Frank?
I'm sorry, Mr. Hawk. Your father's orders.
Come on, Penny. You can see your father
Laura,
later.
Will you please just go upstairs and unpack? Open up, Frank.
I'm afraid Mr. Hawk doesn't want to be disturbed at the moment. He asked me to have all appointments scheduled through Chantal.
Schedule an appointment. Son of a bitch. Laura, wait up.
This seems like a pretty angry family. Oh, am I out of power completely? It looks like it. Don't know if there's anything we can do. Okay, no, now it's just back. All right, I don't know why. But it looks like that even the son has to make an appointment with his father. I'm not seeing the eyeball appear anywhere. We are getting some magnifying glasses. Let's zoom in and enhance on the book on this table. What? Wait, what? Wait. What? Man, where can we buy one of these Philips brand cameras that can open books that are hundreds and hundreds of feet away? Oh, that's not how you close one of those. You don't want to leave the pills out like that. I mean, I don't blame the battery for going down so much. I mean, obviously that would have used a lot of power. Oh, hey, it's Mr. Teddy. I don't know if that's the same Mr. Teddy that was in Blackbay Asylum. If it is, then Mr. Teddy has gotten around. A loving mother and daughter. Doesn't seem like there's a whole lot going on. Let's see if we can find any more, any eyeballs. I want to see some illicit things going on. This is not as erotic as I thought it was going to be. If I want to be honest.
I had things in this room that meant a lot to me, and I want them back. Now! Is that clear?
Well, I suppose we could have some of the help rummage about in the basement, but I don't think we've saved very much.
I don't think I can go through with this.
Well, I guess the help could go through the basement, but I mean, we probably just threw all of your stuff out. Thank you.
Chloe? Chloe? Are you there?
Reed?
Welcome home. Is there anything I can get you? Well, I'll see you later.
Yeah, you can bet on it.
Oh, dear. It seems that there might be something more to Chloe than we might think. I mean, I did not expect the occupant of that room to be, like, an adult. That does not look like who should be in that room. Oh, we can hear stuff. Let's see, let's listen.
That voice. Reed's voice just brings all that shit back. Mom, still living in your own little fantasy worlds if you don't know what went on here. Doesn't she see him for what he is? She just doesn't care. Oh, man. I can't let it get to me. I gotta keep it together. Don't blow it. Just don't blow it.
That sounded... I think that was still Chloe. Looks like she, looks like some bad stuff was going on when she used to live here with Reed. And people are asking, how are we hearing it? I mean, shotgun mics are a thing. We can imagine that we have an incredibly powerful shotgun mic that is picking up this audio. Oh, hold on. Let's see what else we can see.
Come here, slave. Get up.
Oh, wow.
Up on your knees. Yes. Good. Very good. Now take your reward. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Shut down.
Shit.
Chantel.
Yes, Zach? What can I do for you?
I need to talk to you, please.
Oh, well, come in, Zach. Gosh, I'm sorry, Zach. I forgot you released the lock.
Yeah, I understand I have to go through you to get an appointment to see my father.
Yes, I'm afraid that's true. Let me have a look. No. I'm afraid it'll have to be later tonight. I'll let you know, okay?
Fine.
Now, where were we? Come on, bark like a dog. Bark! Howl! Sit! Very good boy. Now I want some real good howling. Yes! Yes, more!
Politics is pretty great, you guys.
Slowly radiated through the entire body. Blending with your sexual energy. Let that empower you. The bond between parent and child is most powerful, but you must not let it interfere with the pathway I've chosen. Yes. Jessica.
Yes.
No.
Yes. Yes.
No.
I don't know why everyone in this house seems to be so angry. I mean, it seems like everyone's having a pretty good time. Yet, I don't... We've seen some pretty angry, nasty people, but I don't know. Seems like some fun times happening in the Reed house. Yes, everyone in this house is having sex all at the same time.
It's the danger that makes it so exciting, Mr. President.
Yes.
Mr. President? Okay, so that was very short. I don't know what was happening. Just something about the danger making it exciting. Did the chat just stop on the screen? It looks like it. Oh, wait, no. Oh, wow. Okay, a lot of just really fast scrolling right there. Okay. So I'm glad that the chat's still here to see this wonderful acting that we're seeing right now. I mean, I just can't appreciate this all on my own. This wonderful interactive acting that's going on. Oh, hold on. Another eye.
I'm not going to wait forever, Zach.
Zach can't please anyone. Zach needs to get his priorities straight. I mean, I don't think we've actually gotten anything incriminating yet. We've gotten stuff that's embarrassing. Not so much incriminating.
Suicide. Or is it my cooperation? After father's accident on the boat. But you appreciate. I know what you're capable of, Reed. And if you try to leave me behind, so help me.
You'll what? You won't do anything because you were there every step of the way. You were a vital part of everything that happened. And if I go down for that, my dearest sister, you go down with me. And we both worked much too hard to let that happen. Haven't we? I have plans for you, dearest heart.
Oh, you do.
Great plans. I have plans for all of us.
Wow, they really do keep it in the family in the Reed household. I mean, that's... Again, I guess we can't actually call the police on that, but it would probably ruin his presidential plans if it was demonstrated that he's, you know, banging his sister. I mean, I'm pretty sure that kind of would put... I mean, maybe... Yeah, I'm pretty sure that someone could not win the presidency of the United States if there was video of him banging his sister. Pretty sure.
I just leave that to
the
people.
To decide. Right. Look. I've received some very damaging information about Hawk Industries. And if you run, I won't be able to keep it from becoming front page news. Concerns certain dumping of toxic waste outside
Sangatsu Village. Yes, I know. Damned containers. They were faulty, we had no way of knowing.
An entire village was contaminated. Dad, people died.
Jess, what do you want from me? I can't bring back the village.
I'm not talking about bringing back the village. I'm talking about you sweeping it under the rug. What kind of president would do that?
Just about any in recent memory. Come on. Suppose it was possible to find a way to eliminate the spread of toxic contamination on a global scale.
Well, anything's possible, but I don't think you realize just how much a project like that could cost.
Educate me. Give me an estimate.
There's organizational groundwork. There's going to be R&D. We're talking at least $100 million just to start.
I can swing that, and I think I know where I can get more.
You're serious about this?
Well, the problem is I haven't the faintest idea how to distribute.
Well, I certainly do. I'm tapped into every eco-network on the map.
Boy, we could really put some teeth into this with a mandate from the UN. I can get that as president.
Are you willing to put all this in writing?
You get your ideas together and I'll call my people. We'll meet tomorrow.
Great.
Jess, you make me very proud.
Thanks, Dad.
Yes, sir.
Get me the file on this Massa character.
So, potential scandal as far as this pollution incident went, and they contaminated a village with toxic waste, but, I mean, there's nothing there where he admitted that they did that deliberately or anything. I mean, he kind of said that they should have known that was going to happen, but would that really be something that could bring him down?
You know, you were right about power.
You got him a knot to run.
He's giving us $100 million to clean up
Jessica,
the whole...
Is Reed still running for president?
Yes. But the point is that... What's wrong with you? He's giving us enough money to really make a
and
difference.
And you believed him!
Martha, we're drawing up the papers.
He is manipulating you like a child.
No, he isn't!
Jessica, you have sold us out!
Oh! All right, so that's Massa. He apparently, his goal is for Reed to stop running for president because he believes that he can't be trusted. And, he's probably right.
Oh, I thought leather would be rough.
Mm-mm-mm. Only when you want it to be. You've got the perfect body for this dress.
Chloe?
What?
Have you seen Laura?
Yeah, she's here.
Laura, Reed will see you now.
Okay. Chloe, could I please have my dress back?
You wouldn't want to keep the old bastard waiting.
All right, so that was Chloe. Nothing really we can use there. Where are Chloe's pants? That is the biggest mystery of all. Maybe we can solve it. Oh, wait. Oh, ran out of time. All right, going on to Sunday, 8:30 p.m. There are no barriers to prevent any two individuals in the manor from having sex? That seems to be what it comes to. Oh, wait, is the phone ringing? Maybe I cut off the message. For hours, we've been spying on these people for days, I think. Can we use the phone to check messages? I mean, the only thing that we get when we put the cursor on the phone is call the police, so I don't think so.
Well, it's about Zach. It's this missile defense thing. I don't know what it is. Something about how you stole it from him. And he spends all of his time at that damn computer. And I think I'm losing him.
Zach is a very, very lucky young man to have a treasure like you looking out for him. I have known that something was wrong between us, but I couldn't. Certainly have helped pinpoint it. The question is what to do about it.
Well, if you could just find the time to talk to him, let him know how much you appreciate his talents.
You really are a very beautiful girl. Come on, I want to show you something.
All right, so we know why Zack is mad at his father, because apparently his father stole the missile defense plans, and also he's taking her off to show her something. I don't know what it is he wants to show her, but maybe we can find out.
Oh.
Reed, they're beautiful.
I've been saving this for you.
No, I can't accept these.
Well, you have to. I gave this to Zack's mother the night that he was born. And just before she died, she told me that she wanted you to have it. So I've just been, you know, waiting for the right moment to give it to you.
I don't think this is it. I'm sorry. Maybe some other time.
I understand.
I'm sure you're very busy, so I will just be on my way.
Of course. That husband of yours is probably wondering where you are now.
Would we want to send the tape to Zack then? I mean, it said, I believe, send the tape to someone who's in danger, but would that be something? I don't know. I don't know if that is enough to actually send the tape. Yes, Reed Hawk is everything. And yes, that does include a pervert who is trying to bang everyone everywhere, no matter how they may be related to him.
You certainly have gotten older.
So have you.
Touché.
How about a drink?
You read my mind. What would you like to have?
Jack, straight up. Grandpa Hawk's old football helmet. Leather. Kinky. Here's to you, Mr. President. Do you know, I laid awake in bed every night after the first time you came to my room. Scared. Not knowing. Listening to every sound. Just waiting for that door to creak open. Your breath on my cheek. The weight of your body pushing me down. No wonder they threw me out of school. It was the only place I could get any sleep. Was it good for you, Reed? Fucking your own niece?
You little slut. Don't play victim with me.
I was 14. 14 years old. You took my life from me, you bastard. When I'm done telling my story, you won't get elected as dog catcher in this country.
Oh. All right. And what do you want?
I want you to pay. My silence is going to cost you $20 million, Mr. President.
You're crazy.
You're absolutely fucking right.
Well, I need a little time to get that kind of money together. On the other hand, I can promise you that if you whisper so much as a word of this to anybody, there will be no place for you to hide.
That seems like something that we could send. Is that enough? It kind of seems like we should sent her the tape. I mean, would she need to get the tape? Or, I mean, she was there. Can we call the cops? Let's try it. Let's try calling the cops and let's see what happens. People already seem to know that it is not enough.
You the one that called with the stuff on Reed Hawk? So show me the tape.
sure.
I just leave that to
the people.
People
to decide, right? Look, I received some very damaging information.
So the fact that we're seeing this, does this mean that this part is considered incriminating? Like, is this the game's way of letting me know that this is one of the clips that we need?
I know. Damned containers. They were faulty. We have no way of knowing.
An entire village was contaminated.
Because we've recorded a bunch of stuff. And for whatever reason, it's choosing this one. So this is a needed part.
I'm not talking about bringing back the village. I'm talking about you sweeping it under the rug. What kind of president would do that?
Just about any in recent memory. Come on. Suppose it was possible to find a way to eliminate the spread of toxic contamination on a global scale.
Well, anything's possible, but I don't think you really...
We didn't record any actual sex, but I don't think we need sex, because we're not trying to embarrass... we're not trying to embarrass him. We're trying to get something illegal on him, which is why we called the police now, because... In that one clip, I mean, he wasn't exactly denying raping his 14-year-old niece. It seemed like he was, he didn't seem like he was kind of admitting it.
How to distribute.
Well, I certainly do. I'm tapped into every eco-network on the map.
Boy, we could really put some teeth into this with a mandate from the UN.
I can get that as president.
He wasn't admitting it completely. I suppose... I guess in the idea that he did not actually say the words explicitly.
Great.
Jess, you make me very proud.
Thanks, Dad.
Can we skip through the segment? Let's see if I press the button. What do we go to?
I never would have thought Reed Hawk was capable of this. But this tape nails him. We'll take it from here.
Was that, I don't know if that was the only clip that counted, or if we would have seen anything else after that. Is the game still... No? Oh, okay. Is that the thing you're really going with? I mean... Oh, no, he's exonerated. Okay. His niece is dead. Okay, she was killed. I mean, his niece is dead. Didn't you see the part on the tape where he was threatening to kill her? I don't think it's a big stretch to put two and two together there. Well, we didn't get caught anyway. So apparently the only thing the police thought was worthwhile was the toxic waste part, and they kind of ignored that last part. So, okay. Did he win in the election? We don't know. It just said that his campaign was gaining momentum. All right, so I guess that's Voyeur, and we didn't die this time, but we did fail in nailing the presidential candidate on anything, I guess, which, apparently it's impossible to win via the police. Do we have to actually send the tape to one of the family members who is willing to actually take him out? Okay, maybe that's the case. Anyway, that's Voyeur, and I think it's about time that we take a little intermission, and we'll come back with some Laser Lords in a few minutes as we just try to figure out why the police thought that one last clip was not actually worth paying attention to. Be back in a few minutes. Welcome back to Laser Lords. So, if you remember last time, we really did not get anything done, or really anything. So I went back and I thought about some of the clues we've been getting. Whoops, didn't mean to go in there. Now, what? Oh, it's pretty quiet. Why is that so quiet? That's a little louder, I guess. Okay, so last time we... Okay, well, am I going to go back to King's Field at some point? Oh, that's a possibility. I do like King's Field, so maybe we should consider that. Daphne dances. No, we know that that is not going to work. That was all just to make that guard angry. One of the items we have here is the Gamean crystal. Now, we got this from the woman who talked only in innuendos. You remember her? She said that if we gave her 200 taras, she'd let us play in the garden. And we paid her 200 taras, and she gave us this crystal. And there was that one guy who works for StatQuo who paid us money for the crystal, saying that it is the key to the garden that Usurp has. So they wanted the crystal. Now, all right, we have the crystal, but where can we use this to find this garden? Well, one of the clues that we got, let me bring this up. There it is. Okay. So where was the thing? It's probably under miscellaneous. We have so many at this point that I don't even see it anymore. One of the clues is that Sadi moved the lock. Have I tried looting bodies? I don't think so. At least I haven't tried it, but maybe we could try it. Sadi moved the lock. She knows where it is.
Unless he has been sent by a woman, I trust.
That's still pretty quiet. Hold on. Maybe that'll be a bit better. All right, so we can tell her that Baka sent us.
I am a servant of the Great Mother. For her sake, I make the magic seeds of Gamia available. I also offer healing.
All right, so she can tell us where this is. We didn't find it the first time we spoke with her.
Thysis gave birth to Gamia and lavished her gifts upon her. Now she weeps to see her children enslaved. Thysis has blessed us.
Nah, that's not it.
Thysis, be blessed. We who honor the great...
Oh, there it is. Garden of Thysis.
...spread her cloak over her sanctuary. No man may enter without the Gamian crystal. If you wish to walk in the garden and speak with the Gamete, you must use the crystal behind a pillar in the city center.
All right, so she's telling us that the lock to the garden is in the city center. So I was looking around. Yeah, we can sell the crystal. It lets us do that. I mean, I'm guessing the game becomes unwinnable if we do, but the game actually does let us do it. Now, I looked around and I found that the column in question is this. Yep, that's the sound effect that we get when we use the crystal. Bow. Not really sure how it makes that sound, but it does. Okay, we found it! We found the garden! This was actually one of our main quests when we started off. The Star-Lord said that we had to find Petra. And here she is! We did it!
I saw your face in the fountain. I knew you were near. I have knowledge for you and gifts.
All right, let's have a conversation.
Flows through the fountain. In its ripples, I see all that happens on Luxor. I saw you. I know your quest.
Now tell us about this Sisis. We know she's a goddess.
I must stay in the shrine until he awakens, or until I am too old to give birth.
What is this all about? What do you know about Seb? We're trying to wake him up.
500 years sleep. I would hate to make children with a monster.
It's an understandable concern.
I'm lucky enough to have them. My children will spread the seeds of Sisis everywhere. That's what the prophecy promises.
And the prophecy promises that you're going to have a lot of kids, it sounds like.
Seb arises. Luxor's chains will be destroyed. Seb shall mate the gamete of Sisis. Sabine children inhabit the void.
Tell us about the gamete. Oh, no, that's just this again. All right, what about the Sabine children? Oh, no, it's just this.
Since childhood, I have tended the garden and watched the fountain. When Seb wakens, I will be free to walk through Luxor again.
All right, so, I mean, she's kind of trapped here, I guess, as the gamete. And so she's waiting for Seb to wake up and fulfill her part of the prophecy. And then she'll be free. I mean, doesn't sound like she has an especially great life, though at least it's nice in the fountain.
I am Petra,
let's ask her name.
Chosen of Sisis and keeper of her shrine.
All right, I think we've hit all these words. So we can choose knowledge and gifts. What knowledge does she have for us?
You must say the chant that wakens him. Then you must demand the soothstone.
Okay, so we're finding out a little bit about what happens when we go into Seb's crypt.
You must use the Sabine seal at the altar of Koptos in order to open Seb's crypt. But I pray you do not go in without the mask of Koptos.
All right, so we haven't actually seen anything about what it is that's going to happen when we go into Seb's crypt. We need the Sabine seal, which I believe is the thing that is guarded by the Haker. But she doesn't want us to go in there without
the
mask of Koptos.
Unless you will be horribly burned when you enter the crypt.
Oh, this is good to know. We should probably get one of those.
Seasons
now, what
fly
is this
like
chant?
Migrant birds. Seb sleeps, the centuries flee. Seb will waken to these words. Seb, set us free.
All right. Why are we freeing Seb again? Well, Star-Lord told us to do it. I mean, he seemed to think it was important. And who are we to question Star-Lord? We do want his sword, but Seb does not have Seb's sword. The guy on Argos has it.
I can't explain everything.
No, I know. All right, so we also want this soothstone.
Seb, to get it from him. Then you must take it to the mother of another planet.
Yeah, good old soothstone Seb. That's what they call him. Let's forget something else. Yeah, I don't think we need that anymore. That was the first password we got. Pretty sure we don't need it anymore.
She may seem hideous to you, yet unless you give her the soothstone, you'll never succeed in your quest.
All right, so there was the mother of another planet that may seem hideous to us, and we have heard references previously to the Queen of Hive. We have not been able to go to Hive, but I'm going to guess it's probably that's probably what it's going to be. Does this game make any sense if you watched every episode of it? You know, it makes a certain amount of sense. It's just that there's so much side stuff, it's kind of hard to focus on what's important.
From your quest. I will have children. Others will have freedom and food, shelter and health. I have gifts to aid you.
All right, let's talk about these gifts.
You have received
hey,
the
we'll
thing
take
you
it.
Seek.
The seed of Sisus right. grows marvelous flowers that will clean the air and restore the soil of a blighted world. Give it to one who is hungry.
All right, someone who is hungry wants this seed. I guess we should remember that.
You have received the thing you seek.
This is a golden gamian. Its scent will bring you vision.
Anything else you have to tell us? I think that's everything. Doesn't seem like there's anything else. All right, so we've met Petra. Let's see. Here's one of the things that we just got. We need to give it to someone who's hungry. What about the golden gamian? Sweet fragrance wafts from the petals. So it smells real nice. Is that going to help us with anyone? All right, so, I mean, hey, we accomplished something here. Now, one other thing that I took a look at since the last time we've played Laser Lords. We had an issue with the propagandist on Argos who has the key to get into the CEO's office and just can't bother giving it to us.
The Cup of Courage, procure it. Offer it to Flatius Dan. If he refuses, there's one way. Draw your laser pistol and shoot him.
That was very specific. Flatius Dan is on Fornax. He is the guy that's guarded by that one mutant who will squeeze us. So if we get the Cup of Courage, we can offer it to him, and if he refuses, we'll shoot him? Let's remember that, I guess. Some people asking if this game is available on GOG. No, the CDI apparently was the only platform this was ever available for. Which is kind of weird. CDI exclusives that actually never came out on anything else. Alright, this is exactly where I want to be. Okay. Remember that we sold something to this guy. By the way, I still have that lunchbox. Let's see. I should have the price list somewhere. Yeah, there it is. He wants 5,000 for the golden necklace. It's a good thing we can afford
Welcome
that.
Welcome to the bazaar, bazaar. Perhaps you seek to buy. Or are you maybe in need of Tara's and wish to sell?
You have received the thing you seek.
There's no emulator that can handle this? Well, I mean, obviously, you look at this and you know you need to play this on the real hardware. No other option. There isn't a CDI emulator. There is a CDI emulator, but from what people say, it seems like it is not great. I don't know too much about it.
How is it? Me? Sam?
Well, how you doing, Sam? Yes, a CDI emulator is not needed, just a Laser Lords emulator. Unfortunately, no such thing exists. Alright, let's beam down. Okay, no more nonsense with this propagandist refusing to give us the key. We're gonna get this key! Mattel owns Spinnaker, so basically Mattel owns Laser Lords, if they even remembered that it existed, which I'm sure they don't. Who would you want a doll of from Laser Lords? I mean, I'm assuming Star-Lord. He seems the most plush doll type of character. There's the robot, too. There's also the guy from Wu, who we talked to, Rikus, whose brain is all scrambled. The villain, Sarpedon. Yeah, you can have a Sarpedon plush. I know. Sarpedon is also a Star-Lord, but our Star-Lord's name is Zendak. I could not hear the name during the intro. But, I mean, we should
Please
be respectful and refer
I'm
to him by his
busy.
Title. So are we.
How dare you barge in, break my concentration, and then demand I give you the key to Neklo's office? Have you no tact?
I don't have tact, but what I do have is a golden necklace.
You seek. How beautiful. Uh-huh. This looks a lot better than that key around my throat.
Why would you wear it as jewelry? Anyway, we have the key. Let's talk to Neklo. How do I use this? Here we go. All right, let's talk to this Neklo guy, see what he's all about. He just looks like a normal Argosian.
State your business or leave.
He doesn't give any options. Let's ask his name.
Of an audience with Neklo, commander of Statquo and CEO of Corinth Carbide.
Oh, so this guy runs Statquo.
We aggressively respond to usurp's assault on progress. We can't let a few malcontents destroy the empire.
Tell us about usurp.
Rhetoric to inflame well-meaning aliens into committing acts of terrorism. You can prevent this.
It's not, we know nothing about something like that. On a completely different subject, are you hungry? It's about time for lunch.
An alien working for usurp killed a teacher, 6 children, and himself in the academy with a bomb concealed in a lunchbox.
Oh, really? Who would do something like that? How can I, a normal everyday Joe, prevent these acts of terrorism?
Your ability to gather data may aid us.
Yeah, I am intrepid as hell. What can I do?
Power mongers who run usurp. This would be your mission.
Well, I mean, I might know some things.
Go with them. Discover their leaders. Names are not enough. You must find documentation.
There is a profound. What kind of documentation would you need?
Terrorists. It is known as the Annals of Usurp. Procure a copy, then.
Well, I might have. You know, theoretically, if I did have that, what then?
Give it to Sodapod, the commander of Lyspacium. This permanent visa will allow you to move freely through Argopolis.
Sodapod. That's the guy that bartender on Fornax wants to kill with an injection sword. Who is Sodapod? Where is this fellow?
Stat quo Grand Inquisitor. His methods are rather unsavory, but people do talk. Sodapod delights in the limits of pain. He's an expert skinner, and he won't hesitate to scoop out an eye with a spoon.
Oh, he seemed like a very pleasant fellow. So, you know, we do kind of have this.
Expertise.
No, I guess Sodapod wants it.
As CEO of Corinth Carbide, I direct the production and distribution of virtually all goods through our many subsidiaries. Corinth Carbide stimulates competition where development is needed and controls production to prevent glut. In technology,
tell me all about it.
Competition is needed to encourage invention. Agriculture, however, must be controlled to keep fruit from rotting in the field.
It all makes sense to me. I guess maybe there's nothing else we can say. Well, I mean, at least we got that permanent visa. I am an alien patriot. All right, I don't know if there's anything else we can do with him. Maybe there are some specific words that could do something. But I don't know if we have anything like that. At least he gave us the permanent visa, and he directed us to go to Sodapod in the Lyspacium. I want to find where that guy is. Because we know someone who wants him dead. On Luxor, can we get past that gate? No. No, we can't. I don't know yet how to get past that gate. I guess we need the real password, but, it's not Daphne Dances. We know that much. Can we toss the temp visa now? I don't know. I mean, we don't have a limit to our items, so we don't need to toss it. We have a limit to our words, but not the items. Speak to Daphne. You know, I tried finding Daphne on Fornax. I talked to the women in the casino, and they didn't seem like they were Daphne. I tried the password and everything. I don't think the kiss me command is actually going to do anything. So I'm just going to look around in the Lyspacium here to see if we can find Sodapod. When I was looking around, I think that's a dead end. When I was looking around last time, I didn't find anyone who identified themselves by that name. That's not him. That's a Tem. And a Tem, we're all right with a Tem. He's pretty cool. Down here is a guy who's very stressed, and in another lifetime, we killed him with a lunchbox bomb. Did he say
Listen,
what his name was?
Listen, I've got half the Star Force fleet coming in. Get the Zook out of here.
I mean, he doesn't want to... Yeah, he doesn't want to listen to us. I'll, let's see if he does anything with this.
Are you trying to get us all killed? Get out! I said get out!
It's not him. I mean, he seems like he's overworked. I'm not going to bother him. Did we kill him? I think only we died. I would assume that both of us died from the explosion, but technically the explosion, I guess, never happened. All right, what about this gentleman here? I'm pretty sure we've spoken to him, but I don't remember who he is.
Head of Star Force Special Forces.
No, that's not who. And you? Oh, I remember this gentleman was very angry.
Slime Pal Neil! Who sent you? Why are you here? Where's the Zookin Fleece?
And he's not telling us his name. What do you think about this? No. It's the only thing he's saying. And I know that over to the left is Lexandollar. And we don't need to talk to him at this point. I was saying that we should get down on our knees. I think I might have done that the first time. But, I mean, we'll try. It did work one time with Nebka.
On your knees, duck-faced slime pal Neil! No. Who sent you?
Maybe I should learn Soda Piss and ask people about it? Maybe. I mean, that guy is the only one in the Lyspaceum that we don't know his name. So it might, we might, and he is pretty angry, so we might assume that he is Sodapud, but we can't do anything with him. I don't think there's anyone else in the Lyspaceum. Try giving him the Annals of Usurp. Okay, I'll try it. I'll go to that guy and give him the Annals. Would it be the Planet Entrance guy? No, Planet Entrance guy, he said what his name was. I don't remember what it was, but it wasn't Sodapud. And Neklo did specifically say that Sodapud is in the Lyspaceum.
On your knees, duck-faced slime pal Neil! Who sent you? Why are you here? Where's the Zookin Fleece?
Does this answer your questions? No, it doesn't. Alright, let's get out of here for the moment. I'll look into that some other time. For right now, there's one thing that I realized. Looking back at the previous Laser Lords videos. That we have not... Yes, Tecton. We have not explored Tecton. We were there for like a minute. Can we go to Wu? No, we need a special engine to go to Wu, and we don't have it.
Yoo-hoo! Yoo-hoo! It's me! Bob! Bob!
Okay, how you doing, Bob? He just wanted to say hi. Alright, here's Tecton. It's the robot planet. So we talked to this one guy, and then we left. So, hey, let's look around. See what we can find. It is a pretty big game. There's quite a few things to explore. I don't know, let's try going up. Maybe that should be our focus for right now. That's a door. Is that a thing? I don't know if that's a thing. No, it's not. Alright, robot. We can probably talk to it.
Organic in the playpen. I've been so bored playing with clunky old droids all the time. Look, we don't even have a swing set.
Okay.
In here. Even the toys are machines. Everything made of metal, computer programmed, right, and self-activated. Not one is as fun as any toy from Woo.
This robot seems pretty, he has a personality.
I was enhanced. The one thing I remember is that everyone knew how to play. They scooped out my
enhanced, you say?
Me for photosynthetics, augmented an interface to my brain, and put me in this casing. Poor monkey me. On Woo, a monkey's
So is this a cyborg?
That's where they play all the time. But for me, play is work.
Are you a Woovian who was turned into a robot?
That's why I can't sneak out of here. I run on steady Tectonese light. The minute I left the planet, I'd malfunction. Unless it was a special ship with Tectonese grow lights, I'd freeze up. So I guess I'm stuck in Prime Pyramid forever.
Maybe we should remember to look into some Tectonese grow lights, whatever those are.
Even the playpen is like an operating room. They stuck in a cranial crystal and sewed on a hunk of Co-Fusion's brain so I'd interface with Prime Ass.
A cranial crystal, you say? I think we're looking for one of those.
Sure, I got one. That's why my head's so lumpy. All the droids have a hunk of Co-Fusion's brain, so Prime Ass can tune in and make sure we're doing our functions. I used to call him Pain.
That's just what you call
until
him?
Until he caught on. He's nothing but a big snoop. That's why he always gets headaches. He gets overloaded all the time.
Tell us about this guy.
In fact, he's offline right now. Shoot, if he heard me talking like this, I'd be disassembled. They tear droids apart, throw the organics into the nutrient pool, and reuse the enhancements. That's how most droids end up. Pretty disgusting, all those body parts floating around. They grind and strain them, then run the mess through tubes to the cloning banks.
Man, this robot planet is a lot messier than I thought it was going to be. What's your name?
The Prime Pyramid. Prior to enhancement, I was a normal monkey swinging among the trees of Woo.
All right, so he is a Woovian.
I'm supposed to play with the droids so that their organic components are stimulated. The worst part is the tickling.
Tell us about the tickling.
While it says, I do not experience the tactile sensation sought in this exercise, some fun.
It sounds like a good old time. I don't know if there's anything that he needs from us. He just seems to not really be having a good time. Okay, that seems to be a dead end. Well, I mean, maybe we'll keep him in mind, and if we find anything that maybe he could make use of, maybe we'll come back. We have to meet the Prime Ass. I mean, this is a big ladder. This is a big, important-looking ladder. Maybe the Prime Ass is on the top of it. We can only hope. And this is a big empty room that was on the top of this important looking ladder. Oh, okay. You look like maybe you're in charge. You're a big robot wearing a cape.
Hey, have you come across any secret specs?
Well, that is not exactly what I expected the King Robot to sound like. I think we do have secret specs. We got them on Argos, but let's talk a little bit before we get into that.
Okay, so I owe ya. So what do you want from the Keeper of Co-Fusion, Autocrat of Tecton? I used to.
Yeah, it is kind of a John Wayne, isn't it?
My body wore out. Transplants wouldn't take, so I hooked up my brain and got rid of the mess.
Okay, so he used to actually be Co-Fusion, who was like the main philosopher that these robots live by. So maybe he was the first robot? I don't know.
Droids, but I got the full-size original. That's why I get to write the program. They just think they can think.
Mm-hmm.
Only one of them has more than a half a pound of brains, and he's a monkey.
Yeah, we met him. He does not think much of you.
Used to be a lot of fun. Well, that's the problem if you leave too much brain in a droid. They get bored.
I guess so.
Usually, I just make it up as I go along. Problem is, I gotta keep track of what I said or the droids will flip out.
Well, yeah, I imagine you're writing a program, you do have to kind of keep track of what you're saying.
I need these guys. You think I should let a bunch of half-wit droids make decisions? I'm the only one with a brain around here. Well, I got 237,578 droids here. Once I get some secret specs for the Helicon engine, I'm gonna build a million and expand into the void.
Oh, I mean, it's great. This seems like a wonderful civilization to expand out.
I heard there were some specs for the new Helicon engine for sale on Argos. Why don't you bring them to me? I'll make it worthwhile. Well, trust me. Look, there's no way you're gonna get an engine like that unless I build it for you. It'll take you all the way to Hive.
Well, I believe we did get the secret specs. Yeah, we have them. All right. I guess we need to give it to him.
I've got everything I need right here except the cube of Fleeton. You'll have to get that for me, too.
Fleeton. Have we seen anything like that?
That's where they mine it.
Right, that's where I heard that. On Fornax, they did say that's what they do in the mines. We didn't find any Fleeton on Fornax, I don't believe. There's nothing in our inventory that's really anything like that. Okay, so I guess we couldn't have thought it would be that easy. That he would just be able to build the engine for us. Still only selling ammo clips. Oh, we have a Mulu nut. Yeah, that's right. Hold on. When I was doing some offline exploring, I found that someone that we talked to on Argos, the blue alien, if we talk to him, like choose some different options, he gives us this. It's a really hard nut. I don't know what we do with it, but we have it. All right, I was hoping that we would just be able to give him the secret specs, and he would build the engine, but he needs a cube of Fleeton. Which I guess means that we go back to Fornax and see if we can get that from anyone. I guess we couldn't have hoped it would be easy. Yeah, I'll keep exploring here, see what else we find on the beautiful planet of Tecton, where everyone is so happy and everything seems so wonderful. What does Prime Ass need with a cape? I mean, that's a good question. Robots generally don't need capes, but I guess he's an exception. He certainly seems to think that he's special. All right, how you doing? What's going on?
Sorry about that. I was just testing out this battery pack. What can I do for you, Organic? We run everything with
I guess tell us about your battery pack.
Can't beat it for efficiency. All we need is a little light. You know, light.
Yeah, I heard about that.
That's what we use for power on Tecton. Shoot, if the sun ever set, we'd all be stuck.
I wonder if that's something I'll need to remember.
Notice the sea. It never lacks power. Use what is in the sea, and you shall never want. That's how we started with plankton. I'm the power droid around here.
What's your name?
They call me Switchon. I assemble and test battery packs.
Very imaginative names on Tecton.
I assemble and test the battery packs. You've got to have a taste for power to do this job. After I put the packs together, I taste them to make sure they have enough chlorophyll. That's why I've got a dozen GEUs here.
Someone asked, wasn't that one of the part of the Analex of Cofusion? I guess not, because if it is, it just automatically tells us that. We don't have to, when we get one of those verses, we don't have to do anything.
Then give it a little charge. Once it's switched on, it runs as long as there's light. With a gustatory enhancement unit, I can taste how much chlorophyll is in each battery pack right down to the last cell.
Let's see, is there anything else we can get from him? It doesn't really look like it. Well, let's continue walking around. This is an extremely pleasant-looking background. It doesn't hurt the eyes at all. Alright, look at this guy. He seems built differently.
Can't you see him up to my electrodes and OIUs? Organic interface.
No, I actually can't see that.
Every boy's gotta have one. Prime S says I gotta make a million or he'll have me scrapped.
I see the play droid is not the only one who calls him that.
Keep up. Jeez. Says I'm gonna get pulled apart because I'm behind. Like I'm doing the best I can. Is it my fault they turned up production?
No, this poor droid's just obviously overworked.
What are they gonna do, take over Argos?
Maybe that is what they want to do.
Got you hooked into the program? Look, tell him transmit's working fast as he can. Program, schmogram, just a bunch of rules to keep us droids online. About as inspirational as Jell-O. Some quivery stuff.
What can you tell me about Jell-O?
Supposed to give us the juice we need. Sheesh, what I wouldn't do for a cup of Cophelia.
Do you want one? Because, I mean, I'm sure I can get one. I don't think I have one on me. Pretty sure I don't. But if you want one, I mean, we could remember that you want one. Pick one up. No, Jiva is not Cophelia. Cophelia is something that we've seen for sale specifically. We actually have not found a use for Jiva as of yet. I mean, it was like the first thing we got, but no one's wanted it. It was a little Rodney Dangerfield-ish, yes. Thought that was an elevator. Or if it is, we can't get on it from there. Let me try this. Oh, nope, too late. Going on this conveyor belt. I don't think Jiva is a healing item. It doesn't say that it does any healing or anything. Or you could, or it does restore your health? We have never actually tried it. Yes, Laser Lords for the next, oh, this is the beginning, at the next AGDQ. Gonna see some serious Laser Lord times. Gonna try to break the world record. This seems like an important looking room. But it doesn't look like there's anything in here, at least for right now. I bet there's some shortcut where you can just complete the game at the very start. It does seem kind of like the type of game where you could do that, doesn't it? Wait, is this the same thing? No, this has no. This is a different stairwell. All right. Oh, I don't think he's actually alive. All right, there's someone who is. The game is very short. It's just there's a lot of red herrings.
So good if you just stop by. I'll be with you as soon as I finish this VEU. So yeah, that should do it.
I can imagine that if you know exactly what you're doing in this game, that you can go through it pretty quickly. Because mostly it's just about finding the correct people and the correct things to say and go from there. Now, I don't think we want to be a donor.
Continuity in the void. Now, when you are ready, we can begin. Here, I'll just take your hand to begin. The rest can wait.
Well, great! We are now effectively immortal. I think that we accomplished some good things on our trip to Tecton.
You must pay
Star-Lord?
More attention to your life force. I cannot continually intervene.
Star-Lord, I mean, we just got our DNA digitized, is what I think just happened. So now, I mean, it's gonna be preserved forever. I think that's probably enough for Laser Lords, and I think that's going to be enough for tonight's stream, because I am getting a little bit tired, and, okay, we did a couple things. I mean, we found the garden, we were able to talk with Neklo, and figure out that we're supposed to talk with Sodapud, we got around on Tecton, and we now know that we need to go to Fornax to get some Fleeton. So many side quests, so many people to talk to. I'm going to try to get it organized. And like I do every time, I'll try to organize it over the week. I'll try to just put it all in the Laser Lord notes so we can figure out what it is we should be doing next time. And I assume that we're not going to, you know, donate anything on Tecton again. And, don't forget, you did vote that we should continue on our adventures in Blackbay Asylum, so I guess we're gonna do that. And, I did mention that the streams will continue to be posted to YouTube, as a lot of people ask me to please keep doing that, so I will. But for right now, I think that is going to be it for Laser Lords and the stream. I am kind of tired, so I think that we'll end the stream now, because, previous to the stream, I was recording, for D4, so, it looks like I'm on track to meet the date that I set in the podcast of, Friday of next week, to start off the D4 LP, and then hopefully be able to continue on with a weekly schedule. I'm going to try to get a weekly schedule of Friday, post them on Fridays. That seems like that would be pretty good. Arloa, what about I Love My Pet? Oh, believe me, I am not done loving things. I have more love to give. Exclusive 3DS love. So, yeah, there's more love. And so we'll see about that. But hopefully D4 will indeed be happening on time. And we'll see how that goes. But for right now... Right now, as in like half a minute. Yes, there we go. As for right now, I think it's about time to put an end to the stream. So I hope everyone had a good time with the CDI and Laser Lords, as well as our new thing, Blackbay Asylum. And we'll see if we can continue on. Saki, you're asking if I will play the second Sin and Punishment game? Yeah, that's going to happen at some point. I mean, there are so many games to go back to. But yeah, Sin and Punishment 2 on the Wii is one of them that I intend to do. So, just kind of slurring my speech at this point. So, have a good night, everyone. Have a good week. I hope you look forward to D4. And, hopefully by the next time we meet for a stream, hopefully that first video will be up. And if it's not, then you can yell at me. I'll see you next time.